hear me?
Yes, sir. Sir, before you start, let me narrate the parameters what we are going to operate in this patient.
Yes.
Sir, patient is having the A1 of the 44.06, A2 44.47. Axis is 159 for the 44.47. Axial length is 31.96. Quite a big. Tachymetry is 560 and anterior chamber depth is 3.61 and wide to wide. It's not over here.
It's 11.8.
11.8.
Yes.
And Dr. Pandey is going to implant the IPCL. We are used to using the ICL, and this is a new product from the Indian company, and this is a really very good product, and he's going to demonstrate how he's going to implant, and if possible we are going to discuss the advantages.
Ophthalmology Society and Care of India for giving me opportunity to demonstrate the implantation of the IPCL in this 29 years. So this is the correct orientation of the IPCL. I'm sorry, it's just slipping because it's very thin. And you can, these two tiny holes are there on the optic. And once you, these two tiny holes will be there on the superior side. I'm just going to put it on. You can see here, once you implant, the orientation is very important. These two tiny holes will be there on the superior optic.
Okay.
You can see the hole on the left side. This is the leading left landmark. So once the IPCL goes inside, this hole on the haptic should be on the your left side.
And exactly opposite of the ICL.
Yeah, exactly opposite of the ICL. And this IPCL contains total 6 holes, and each hole is 400 microns. So total area is 2400 microns. And these two holes, tiny holes on the optic, are there on the superior side. And because the location is like that it avoids any glare and halos. Even the pupil is dilated, in night driving, because these holes are there on the superior optic and this part is covered by the upper lids. And these two holes are there on the optic haptic wall. And there are two holes here, two holes here. So there are 4 holes here. Then these are the six holes. And these two holes on the optic area, they ensure the continuous aqueous outflow from posterior chamber to anterior chamber. And this is the thickness of the IPCL is 50 to 100 micron, and the available power is from plus 15 diopter to minus 30 diopter. And they have the care group is manufacturing the IPCL, which can correct up to 8 diopter cylinder also. So the advantage of the IPCL is that it is like very easy and simple to load it, and it is manufactured from hybrid acrylic, hydrophilic acrylic material with 26% water content. And so far, more than 5,000 IPCL has been implanted worldwide by 350 different surgeons. And we have implanted 30 cases, we have done 30 cases so far, and so far the results are very encouraging. So once you put the IPCL in the correct orientation with leading the hole on the leading left side, after filling the viscoelastic, which is HPMC, in the cartridge, you just gently just tug it like this way by pressing gently with the MacPherson portion, and then close the cartridge. You are familiar with this injector. This is very, most of the doctors are familiar with this injector. So you just put this injector gently, and this IPCL is ready to go. So once you load the IPCL properly in the cartridge, then the surgical procedure, we start the surgical procedure by creating the side port incision first. For the side port incision, I prefer to use preservative-free intracranial lignocaine. This is 0.1% of preservative-free intracranial lignocaine. Then I'm injecting 2% hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, and for any phakic IOL surgery, the implantation for phakic IOL implantation, I am carrying the main incision, which is on temporal side, which is
3.2 millimeter keratome.
This is 2.8 millimeter keratome.
So you can implant the IPCL with 2.8 millimeter keratome.
I'm just taking a little viscoelastic because this is the myopic eye with deep vintage chamber and 31 millimeter angel length. So this is, and so after creating two side port incision and one main incision, I'm implanting the IPC here, and you can see the leading, the hole on the leading left optic. If you can make out the hole, the IPC is unfolding gently. This will be directed towards the iris plane. So notice the beautiful implantation of the IPCL.
They will go on the interior side, isn't it?
Yeah, the leading will come on the side, right? Yes.
So, like, you know what you are saying, because they will be covered under the upper lid, there won't be any glare. So, in that case, that time you have some glare.
No. These two holes will be superior side. I am talking about this hole on the,
yeah,
on the leading, the hole on the leading haptic. On, while implanted on the right eye, that hole will come superior side, but when you implant on the left eye, that leading hole will come inferior side, but the two tiny holes on the optic area will stay on the superior side. So once I implant the lens, then I will I'm just going to tuck the haptic pads. You can see this lens has different, three different haptic pads. I'm just going to gently tuck them. So this is, you can see it's very easy to tuck them. Behind that is, this is the IPCL manipulator. This is just gently tuck the lens. So once you tuck the lens from the distal haptic, and you can tuck them from proximal haptic as well.
Basically, the reason why we don't overfill in the IPCL is the reason the iris retroflexes when we overfill. So it's difficult to do this step whenever we overfill it with the viscoelastic. So it's an ideal thing is to just about fill it to the normal chamber. Your pupil should not dilate when you're injecting the viscoelastic. In case it does, you need to decrease, you need to remove out the viscoelastic.
Yes, you are right. So once after tucking the iris, I'm just going to remove the viscoelastic.
So the previous designs did not have these vents on the optic zone. So we needed to do a PGI either with a laser or on table, so that the glaucoma doesn't set in. And we also need to look in preoperatively whether the patient has an adequate open angle, and if it is a shallow angle, then it is contraindicated.
So with this design, the preoperative laser or surgical PIE is not needed, because these holes, they have a total area of 400 micron seats. So we are just there, 2400 micron area is there to provide continuous exchange of the aqueous.
We would like to ask you a few questions, sir.
Yes, sir.
But with the time constraint, like, when you come back to the auditorium, we are going to ask you about this IPCL product.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Sir.
Thank you very much for all the trouble you have taken to come all the way from Kota and making this occasion even better.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
કેવું દેખાય છે?
સારું દેખાય.
પેલા કરતા કેટલો ફેર પડ્યો?
બહુ સરસ.
I want to make one comment. Last conference, it's Rajasthan Ophthalmological Society. Someone asked us about the explantation procedure of the IPCL. So at that time, we do not have an experience that time. But now we have one case where we had a chance to take it out because that case, you know, developed trauma, and because of trauma, he developed traumatic attack. So the explantation procedure of the IPCL is very simple and straightforward. If you explant it, then you just need to dislodge the haptics and just bring it towards in the empty chamber. Then you simply by pulling it, it comes out very easily. So one of the most important fear which a surgeon need to overcome in the beginning is the glaucoma and cataract. You know that the sizing is very important. If you measure it correctly, wide to wide measurement is very important, and you should use a digital caliper to measure it precisely. And if you like you know over measure it, over measurement of the wide to wide, then it can lead to glaucoma, and under measurement of the wide to wide diameter, it can lead to anterior subcapsular cataract. So for implanting the IPCL, it's very important to do the proper measurement. It's very important.
What Dr. Pandey means, like, you know, it's a small IOL. I mean, small ICL. The vaulting will be in the touch of the anterior surface of the crystalline lens, and that scenario can give rise to some cataract. So vaulting is very, very important in the case of the ICL. And suppose ICL is big or the IPCL is big, then the vaulting lens will be curved in the angle like this. And that scenario can cause the rise in the intraocular pressure. In both the scenario, you have to explant the lens. Okay, now coming to the sizing of the ICL or the IPCL, wide to wide is very important. You can measure wide to wide manually with the calipers. That's the best method available. But there are IOL master measurements. Those measurements are not exact measurements, but there is a formula. It has been developed by the intraocular IOC company with the IOL measure, IOL power, wide to wide from the optical biometry, they can convert into the regular wide to wide. But what is suggested is off-skin wide to wide is the best method. It is very close to the actual measurement of the bag. So only through the horizontal, yes. And with this new ICL and IPCL, iridectomy problem is more or less solved. Otherwise, we have to ask this patient for the YAG capsulotomy, YAG PI beforehand. Then otherwise, you take the patient after the procedure with the iridectomy cutter and do the iridectomy. That is.
You had case of presbyopic IPCL
I just like you know they have introduced this IPCL presbyopic. I'm very excited,
yeah.
And most probably in near future I'm planning to implant one. Do you have any experience?
Yeah, you know I have not implanted yet, but this is one of the most exciting way to correct the presbyopia, because they can correct from plus 1.5 diopter to plus 3 diopter, and they can correct myopia and hypermetropia as well. And they can incorporate that power, you know, in the percentage, like say hypermetropic and presbyopic, they can do both.
Are they on? They want to start? Please.
Yeah, 2.8 millimeter. You can remove 2.8.
Okay, we can start from Narayan Netra. Please go ahead.
Thank you.